Hi everyone. Today I want to share with you all the different types of lilies so that you can really extend the lily season by planting multiple divisions of lilies that bloom at varying times. And I think when most of us hear the word lily, we immediately think of the highly fragrant and oh so popular stargazer lily. And while the stargazer lily is certainly a beautiful flower, there are literally hundreds of other lilies to choose from. Some are quite tall with dainty flowers, some are short with no fragrance at all, some carry loads of trumpets on each stem, and some can even be grown in the shade. Lilies are categorized into different groups, also called divisions, according to various traits that they share in common. Let's take a look at the most commonly grown and sold type of lilies in the order which they bloom in the garden. First up is the Asiatic lily, and these are the earliest lilies to bloom. They're very easy to grow, and they're also unscented. So if you love the look of lilies, but don't really care for the fragrance, then the Asiatic lily is the one that you want to plant in your garden. They come in a rainbow of bright colors and face upward, which makes them easy to tuck into hand-tied bouquets. No staking is necessary for these 2 to 3 foot lilies, and their shorter stature makes them a wonderful choice for container gardening. Recently, double Asiatic lilies have become available, the main difference being they possess 2 layers of petals instead of one. Since these doubles are pollenless, you don't have to worry about them shedding pollen and staining fabrics after being cut. Now, blooming alongside the Asiatics, but within an entirely different group, we find the Martagon lilies. And these lilies are quite tall, with many small, dainty flowers all along their stem. These are often referred to as Turk cap lilies, and sometimes a stem can hold up to 50 flowers. Unlike most lilies, Martagons appreciate some shade and are quite decorative in the woodland garden. It may take them a few years to become established, but they're certainly a talking point once they get their footing in the ground. Next up, we find the longiflorum lily, and longiflorum lilies are often referred to as Easter lilies, and these plants have been gracing holiday tables for generations. Often sold as potted plants, these lilies have beautiful white flowers, a very strong scent, and an elegant trumpet shape. Now, next up on our list are the trumpet lilies, and trumpet lilies are tall and dramatic with highly fragrant blooms. Stems can reach heights of 4 to 6 feet tall with long, narrow trumpets for blooms along the stem. They come in dazzling and sophisticated shades of purple, gold, and even silvery raspberry. There certainly will be no missing these beauties in the garden. Trumpets look best in the middle or back of the border and will need stake to support the weight of their flower heads. The next 4 hybrid lily varieties are crosses between 2 parent plants, and you can see both names of each parent represented in the new name of the hybrid lily. And these modern hybrids are bred to be robust performers in the garden, carrying the best traits of both parent plants. They are often wonderful cut flowers, strong perennializers in the garden, and they also carry a lovely fragrance. OA lilies are a cross between the Oriental and Asiatic lilies, and these flowers combine the bold colors of the Asiatics with the bigger flowers and taller height of the Oriental lilies. LA lilies are a cross of the longiflorum and Asiatic lilies and are a favorite of flower farmers and florists. OT lilies are a cross of the Oriental and trumpet lilies. These lilies are outstandingly beautiful, robust, and durable, with a spicy fragrance and large bloom heads. LO lilies are a cross between the longiflorum and oriental lilies and have fragrant, large flowers which are outward-facing and trumpet-shaped with curved petals. Now, lily breeding continues, and you can find more crosses such as AOA, along with what I imagine will be even more crosses and introductions in the years to come. Now, my personal favorite of all the lilies is the tried and true fragrant oriental lilies. And I don't think I've ever seen or smelled an oriental lily that I didn't want to grow in my garden. These are the last lilies to bloom in the garden. They have large, open, and outward-facing flowers, which can be white, yellow, pink, raspberry, or rose, often with freckles, stripes, or halos in contrasting colors. Just a few stems of oriental lilies will fill an entire room with fragrance for a full week. Recently, double oriental lilies have been released onto the market, and their double layers of frilly petals are sure to captivate even the most skeptical lily critic. Now, last on our list are the species lilies, and species lilies are wild lilies that are found in North America, Europe, and mostly Asia. It is from these wild lilies that breeders have created magnificent hybrids for our gardens. Most hybridized species lilies have reflex petals and long anthers. These lilies are ideal for sheltered areas and naturalistic plantings, and most varieties have little to no fragrance. Well, I hope that by chatting about some different types of lilies that you've seen some you might want to grow in your garden and to use as cut flowers in the vase. And currently, the most widely grown types of lilies for cutting are the Asiatic, the Oriental, the LA, the OT, and the AOA. But certainly for the home gardener, grow whatever lily you love and cut them however you see fit. But let's say you want to get the longest vase life from your lilies, or perhaps you're selling to a retail customer. You want to go ahead and pick the lily in what we call colored bud stage. This is where I can tell exactly what color this lily is going to be, and the bud is nice and plump. Now, after I cut this lily and put it in water to condition, it will gradually open as the hours and days progress, giving me the longest vase life. And something you also want to do with lilies is to go ahead and remove the pollen anthers, because the pollen can really stain fabrics and upholstery, and it's very hard to get out. So all you do, once your lilies go ahead and open in water, just take a Kleenex or a cloth that you don't care about, grab the pollen anthers and give it a gentle pull, and they'll all just come right off. And then you can go ahead and dispose of these pollen anthers. And not only does that get rid of the pollen problem, but it also prolongs the life of your cut lily flowers. Now, when using lilies as cut flowers, it's important to leave at least a third of the stem and foliage behind to die back naturally in the garden in order to replenish the bulb for next year. Or you can just choose to treat lilies as annuals and plant the bulbs each season. Another great idea would be to plant lilies in pots, some shorter varieties like the Asiatic. Then you can cut the lilies as you please from your container gardens and leave the lily show in the garden to enjoy. Well, I sure hope this chat on different lily varieties and all their unique characteristics was helpful. Happy gardening. Bye.